And now, back this side of the Atlantic, one of the most important and largest events on the Irish-American calendar, the American Ireland Fund's annual gala in New York. This year's guest of honor was U2 frontman Bono. It was, if not a beautiful day, a beautiful evening. Celebrities, politicians, business leaders, and the Irish-American community came out in force to support the work of the American Ireland Fund. Originally founded in 1976, the organization is part of the largest network of people of Irish ancestry, dedicated to raising funds for causes both sides of the Atlantic.
It's founded 35 years ago, actually. This is the 35th anniversary of the first New York dinner. It was founded by Tony O'Reilly and Dan Rooney. And they essentially wanted to have a focal point for the people who were from Ireland and came to America and wanted to stay involved with things back home. And then they started, they sort of were the victim of their own success. One thing led to another. And over those 35 years, we have raised over $300 million tax-free for the people of Ireland and have helped thousands and thousands of projects. So it's a glorious success, and I'm just humbled and proud to be involved with it.
The New York Gala is usually the Ireland Fund's largest fundraiser, and this year was no exception. Over 1,300 people gathered at the tent at Lincoln Center for the 35th annual event. Irish Americans traveled from near and far for the big occasion. The 70-member dinner committee ensured that every seat available was occupied.
You're supporting two very specific projects.
Tonight is the biggest event of 100 we organize around the world, and it has succeeded beyond our wildest dreams. We're oversold by about 200 places. We have 1,300 people in this tent. We could have had 1,500 if we had the room. We set ourselves a goal of raising $2.5 million, which was a very ambitious, very bold at the beginning of the year. We're topping off at over $3 million, which in this day and age is an extraordinary tribute to the generosity of Irish America.
Now, where will the $3 million be going?
Well, it'll fund our general work. We support about 200 projects across Ireland, North and South. But specifically, we're making two very large gifts to two projects. One is the Forgotten Irish campaign, which works with some of the older and the more isolated members of the Irish American community. We work through centres in this city. Some of these people live in very, very demanding circumstances because over their lifetime, they gave so much back to Ireland through emigrants' remittances. So this is our chance to just give back. And then, at the other end of the age scale, we're making a very significant gift to the U2 Ireland Fund's musical initiative. You know, for a country that has such a proud musical heritage, it's quite surprising to learn that it is one of the lowest access of instrumental training, musical training in the developed world. We're setting out to change that with our partners U2, rolling out a scheme that will result in musical and instrumental training becoming a core subject in all of Ireland's schools.
Music was the big theme of this year's event, with performances outside and inside the tent. But the major attraction was, of course, Bono. He was here to promote his latest cause, the Music Network Scheme, an initiative to bring musical training and instruments to Irish children. You too have already donated $7 million to the project, and in partnership with the American Ireland Fund, hope to reach their $10 million target.
We're here to talk about the music network scene, which is very important to us, anyone interested in music. In Ireland, we have musicians, you know, we have more musicians per head of population in Ireland than any other country in the world, but that's declining. And we just don't think it's fair that a kid, because of their background, can't get access to music tuition. So U2 has teamed up with the Ireland Fund, and we're hoping other people will join. And we're just going to make sure that anyone who wants a music lesson will get a music lesson.
Now, was there music around you growing up, and how important was it?
Music was everything to me, but I didn't have music lessons, and there's a lot of people out there think I probably should have, but I'm one of them. It was a source of endless frustration to me. and still is, actually. I would have loved to have played better.
And that's why you think that this network for children is very important?
Yeah, I just think it's a part of who we are, being Irish. Is this music is a spiritual thing almost for the country. Means a lot to us, a kind of sacrament music. And I just don't think it's fair that people, if they have if they can't afford it, can't get access to music lessons. So we want to change that.
I want to thank the American Ireland Fund for what you've done.
Later inside in his address before the large crowd, Bono continued to stress the importance of music and education, not just as a source of entertainment, but as a source for inspiration and intellectual discipline.
Einstein was a great, great musician, a violinist. He had lessons from the age of 6. He said, "If I were not a physicist, I would probably be a musician. Life without playing music is inconceivable to me," he said. "I often think in music. I see my life in terms of music. I live my daydreams in music." His second wife, Elsa, talked about how he used music to work on his theories. He leaves the study, she said, strikes a few chords on the piano, jots something down, then returns to the study. Thomas Jefferson, there's another one, another keen and talented violinist. I'm telling you, he made special cases, carry case for the violin, and he would take it on his horse, put it on his saddle, and take it with him wherever he went. About playing music, he said, "An enjoyment, the deprivation of which cannot be calculated." He used to play his violin while working on the Declaration of Independence, when he was stuck for prose, can't imagine. But what a band he had, and what great lyrics. Mr. Jefferson, that we hold these truths to be self-evident, life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That's a hit. Number one on the pop charts all over the world to this very day. Perfectly composed.
Obviously, you too care a lot about this issue, children and music.
Yes, indeed. And they were at a school where there was a very good music teacher, and that's how their band formed. And lots of bands have formed in that school. But also lots of classical musicians and jazz musicians have come out of the same school. But that doesn't happen everywhere. And what the scheme that we're funding is trying to do is make it possible for every child in every school in the country to have access to music education.
The other big star of the evening was Bill Clinton, who received a standing ovation. In his remarks, the former saxophone-playing president also discussed the importance of music and its impact on his life.
I especially want to say a thank you to Bono and you two for their partnership with the Ireland Fund to support music education. I have said many times that had I stayed in music, I never would have been the greatest saxophone player who ever lived, and I figured it out when I was 16. But I don't think I ever would have been president if I hadn't been exposed to music as a child.
Bill Clinton was not the only politician to attend this year's festivities. The large crowd included New York City's two most powerful leaders, City Council Speaker Christine Quinn and Mayor Michael Bloomberg, who feels music should also be a priority in New York City schools.
This is a great organization, raises money. In this case, the money's going for help music programs in Irish schools. We care very much about music in our own schools in New York City and trying to do the same thing. And there's a big percentage of our city, remember, was built by the Irish. It still is a pretty big group. What's happening is people are coming from around the world the same way as the immigration from Ireland and from Eastern Europe and from all over the world. One group after another, each one adds to our culture and our cuisine and our language. And I said before, it was nice enough to do something, and I said, I wanted to say congratulations in Gaelic, and I think it's Mazel Tov, isn't that it? Think so.
The American Ireland Fund dinner is always an amazing night. It's a huge crowd. It's everyone coming together to make sure we have enough resources to support important causes back home, to have somebody like Bono here tonight who sends such an important message about the power of Irish creativity and the power of Irish culture and music at a time when we all need a little inspiration. I think we'll get a lot of that out of tonight's event.
There's a great atmosphere here tonight, isn't there?
It feels like St. Patrick's Day.
The heart is a bloom. It shoots up through.